Do you want to recover lost sales and boost your revenue and conversions inside of Kajabi? Of course you do. So in today's video, I'm going to show you the process for setting up and optimizing cart abandonment emails inside of Kajabi. And we're going to talk a little bit about the analytics and how to track those abandoned carts and conversions. One of the downsides to the Kajabi analytics system is that as of today's date, they don't really provide a lot of ways to track your conversions or even your abandoned carts, even though in several articles on their own website, they mention the importance of tracking these sorts of metrics. In one of their articles, it states, pay close attention to your email marketing statistics. What are your cart abandonment rates overall? What are the open rates of your abandoned cart emails? And what are your click-through rates? So obviously, Kajabi thinks that these metrics are important because they mention them on their own website in their own articles. But do they provide us with those tools right as of right now? No, they really don't. But the great thing about Kajabi is that they are always adding new features and new metrics, and they listen to their community and their users on what features we would like to see implemented, and they're constantly adding new features every month. Really, the only metrics that Kajabi provides for us, aside from being able to track how many sales we have, and you can kind of track those types of conversions, are page views. And if you go under the analytics tab on the left-hand side of your account, and then you select page views, which is where I'm at right here under my account, you can see down the right hand side here that you can filter by landing pages, your offers, and your website pages. So if you simply click on the offers tab, you can select the offers that you want to track. Right now it's tracking all of my offers. So if I come down here, you see here offers by view, and it will kind of give you some data as to how many total views you've had or how many views for each of your offers you've had. Now this doesn't give you a lot of statistics or information about the cart abandonment or even the conversion rates on this, but at least gives you an idea that, hey, I'm getting traffic, you know, to my offers, I'm getting traffic to those products. And then what you can do is basically compare this against your sales, and that'll kind of give you your conversion rate. And I should probably mention in the first place that Kajabi doesn't have carts per se. Okay, when someone goes to buy one of our products or one of our offers, they're going to be sent to a checkout page. And only if they start to fill out the information on that checkout page and they don't hit the, you know, purchase now or submit button, is an abandonment cart email going to get sent out. But you've got to make sure that you set up those abandoned cart emails ahead of time. So right now I want to share with you a couple ideas on how to improve your conversion rates with prospects who have gotten away simply by using abandoned cart sequences. And the great part is that this can all be set up on autopilot, so you can set it and forget it. And if you stick around to the end of this video, I'm going to share with you one more method that I've used in the past to kind of recoup some of that income from potential prospects who have basically jumped ship from the checkout page. So if you're not familiar with what abandonment cart emails are they are automated emails that go out after someone obviously has abandoned the cart, meaning they've put in their email, their name, maybe their credit card or Apple, they've selected Apple Pay or something like that, and then they've abandoned the page or they've closed the page. Maybe they got busy, maybe they decided against it, maybe they wanted to think about it. So when they leave that page or they close that page, an email is going to be automatically sent out at an interval that you specify. I always recommend within an hour or maybe 4 hours, because you want to, you know, stay fresh in their mind that day, because the longer the time goes on that they're not purchasing, the harder it is going to be to get them to convert and purchase your product. So the email goes out and it says, hey, you know, hey, you left this page. I just want to make sure that you're still interested in this product. You can even sweeten the deal a little bit. And that's the automated email that you can set up in Kajabi. But one of the issues with Kajabi is that they only allow you to send one automated abandoned cart email. So you really get only one last ditch effort, right? To try to encourage them to complete their purchase. There are a lot of other platforms out there that actually allow you to create a sequence of emails that are actually triggered by the abandonment cart email. And this is something I would like to see Kajabi implement here in the future. I tried everything I could to set up different automations so that once the abandonment cart email went out, if they didn't respond to that email, they were automatically added to another automated email sequence so that I could kind of nurture them over the next few days. So in trying to figure out if there was a way to automate a longer email sequence in case they didn't respond to the one abandoned cart email, I asked Kajabi's own AI about the abandoned cart email sequence. And this is what the AI told me. In a general sense, to implement a follow-up strategy effectively, you would typically set up an email sequence that begins with the initial cart abandonment email. If the recipient doesn't complete the purchase within a set time frame, a follow-up email is automatically sent. You can customize the sequence with multiple follow-ups spaced out over days or weeks and tailor the content to gently nudge the potential customer back to their cart. So even Kajabi's own AI talks about the importance of not sending just one abandonment cart email, but sending a follow-up sequence of emails to kind of convince that person to come back and purchase your offer or your product. But as of right now, like I said, they currently don't have that feature, and this is something that I'm hoping that they'll implement in the near future. So now let's go into my dummy dashboard so I can show you how to set up the abandonment cart email underneath your offer. So right now I'm in the coaching tab under my dummy account, and this is the product that I set up to run this test. So if you go under this drop down on the left under sales and then choose offers, because this is where you're gonna set this up. You're gonna go to the offer that's associated with the product. And if you're not sure what this means, if you set up a product once, you can have many different offers, actually as many offers as you want. Think of the offers as price tags, right? So you can create one product and you can sell it at different price points or offer different discounts, offer different bundles, bundling that, like that product with another product, things like that. So under the offer section that of the offer that was created for this product, right here, example coaching, we're going to click inside of there and we're going to go up to this tab that says settings. And as you notice right down here on the right hand side, send cart abandonment emails. So we're going to check that on. Now real quick, I do want to mention that if you're interested in trying out Kajabi and playing with the platform a little bit and seeing if it is right for you, if you don't have Kajabi already, then I want you to consider using my link at michaeldoms.com/Kajabi. This link is an affiliate link and it will provide you with a 30-day free trial of Kajabi instead of the standard 14-day free trial that they have if you just go to their website alone. And not only that, but I have a lot of bonuses that I'm going to give you. I have a course called Kajabi Kickstart, which is absolutely free to you when you sign up for your 30-day trial through my link. This is actually a paid course that I offer for people who already have Kajabi. But again, it's absolutely free to you when you sign up using my link. And of course, once you sign up, you can mess around with the platform. You can follow along in the course to help you get set up. Once you sign up for your 30-day free trial, you'll automatically get an email sent out that gives you access to the free Kajabi Kickstart course, as well as an ebook that I created specifically for the course called 30 Days to Profits, which is designed to walk you through how to make money, actually start making profits within your first 30 days on the Kajabi platform. Not only that, but if you'd like to take advantage of it, inside the course there are instructions on how to take advantage of a free 45-minute one-on-one coaching call with me to help you get your Kajabi account set up and help you get rolling, answer any of your questions. And we can also share screens if you need help getting your Kajabi platform set up and running. So once you check on the send cart abandonment email, you're going to select when you want that email to go out. I always suggest about an hour later so that they just need a gentle reminder. Maybe they stepped away to take care of their kid. Maybe they stepped away to go to dinner. Maybe they had a business meeting. It kind of just gives them a gentle reminder like, hey, you know, you were checking out this product. Why don't you come back and finish filling out the form? Because obviously, if they're getting the abandonment cart email, they actually started putting in their information on the checkout page. So you just want them to complete that purchase. One thing that you can do, and I don't really recommend it for the first email, especially if you only have one email that goes out, is you could offer a coupon code, because you can create coupon codes also in Kajabi. You can offer some sort of discount if they want to come back and revisit. But I would always give them the opportunity to come back and complete that purchase. And then that's where an email sequence would come in handy, because if they don't come back and complete that purchase, then after you nurture them for a couple of days, maybe on day two or three, then you can offer them a discount or kind of like a downsell, right? If they come back and complete that purchase, or you can even sweeten the pot for them and offer them more stuff if they come back and complete that purchase. So that's why it's important to have a multi-email sequence rather than just one email that goes out. But for right now, this is what we got and it works great. Now I'll just really quickly show you how to customize the template. So if we click down here where it says edit reminder email template, so we're gonna click on that. And this takes you to your email templates page, which you have inside of Kajabi. And these are all your business's email templates that are all standard default. You can go in and edit any of these and customize them, add your own logos, things like that. So the fifth one down says cart abandonment. So we're gonna click on the edit button and this is the email. Right now it's very, very simple and you can add what you want to this email. You know, hey, you know, your subject, your purchase isn't complete. Hey there, we noticed that you're about to purchase. Here's your offer title. It's automatically put in for you, so I wouldn't mess with that. That'll just link to whatever that offer title is. It's just gonna show up in their email. But didn't finalize your order. To complete your order, simply click the link below, and then this button is there, and it takes them back to that checkout page so they can complete their offer. So for example, if you're not happy, you know, with the subject line, you can say something like, hey, we noticed you checking us out, checking out our coaching program. You know, so basically the gist of it, you get it, is that you can customize this email to say whatever you want, or you can just leave it as the default because the default works great and it gets them to come back and purchase and you never have to worry about it again. Once you turn it on, it runs on autopilot. Now, a couple things to keep in mind. The cart abandonment email will not go out if obviously you have not turned on the abandonment cart email. But also, if your product or your offer is free, they will not get an abandonment cart email. So it must be on a paid product. Also, that email won't go out if that user abandons their cart, but then comes back within that hour, 4 hours, or whatever you specified and makes the purchase. That email is then canceled and it won't go out to that user. Now, one that a lot of people don't know about, and especially if you're new to Kajabi or you're not sure how like the upsells work or not, when you create a checkout page, you have the option to put like an order bump or even an upsell page after they've clicked the, yes, I want to purchase this product button. So in this case, the drawback to having an upsell page is that that abandonment cart email will not go out. If someone has put in their information and clicked, you know, make a payment or purchase this product, and then you direct them to an upsell page and then they abandon the cart, that email will not go out. Now for your bonus tip. Because of the limitations as of right now in Kajabi's system in running these emails for us, another great way that I've used in the past to retarget people who have visited my checkout pages is by running retargeting Facebook ads. Now, we're not going to go super deep into Facebook ads or retargeting ads right now in Facebook, but I just wanted to mention this as an alternative for those of you who know how to do it, or I could possibly do an upcoming video for you. If you guys are interested in seeing something like that, you know, comment below, let me know. But all you really have to do is install your Facebook pixel into your Kajabi account, which I'm going to show you how to do here in just a second. Then you're just going to set up a retargeting ad that runs on autopilot that basically targets certain events. And I know I'm probably speaking gibberish to those of you who don't understand what I'm talking about, but in Facebook ads, you set up an event and a retargeting ad will automatically go out when that event or that step takes place on a certain page. So if somebody visits a certain landing page or your checkout page or takes a certain step, like, you know, putting in their email address, same thing as kind of filling out the form and then abandoning the cart. It's the same idea. But if they visit the later when they log into social media, and that's where people, you know, most people spend all their time anyway, is that they're going to get this ad in their feed, which can basically be the same information that you would have sent to them in an email sequence. And you could actually set up an ad sequence as well. So if this is something that you're interested in using as well to be able to recoup some of those conversions, I'm going to show you real quick where to put your Facebook pixel in your Kajabi account. And one thing that I do want to mention really quick is that as of right now, the Facebook pixel and like Google Analytics, things like that, the tracking codes do not work with the pop-up checkout pages. And if you're not sure what those are, I recently did a video on pop-up checkout pages. It's basically a shorter, simpler version of your checkout page that pops up whenever a certain call to action is triggered, like pressing a button or something like that. But currently those codes do not work with those. So if this is your plan to run Facebook ads to, you know, retarget some of those visitors that maybe jumped away and didn't purchase your product, then I would recommend just redirecting them to an actual checkout page so that your Facebook pixel can track that data. So let me show you real quick where to go in your Kajabi account to set up your Facebook pixel. So once you have your Facebook pixel, and if you're not sure how to do that, there's videos all over the internet. And if you're interested, I can produce a video on how to do that. Just comment below and let me know that's what you want to see. But once you have that code, you're just going to come down here to the left-hand side in your account under settings. And then you're going to come over here to the middle where it says third-party integrations and webhooks. And if we scroll down right here, here's the option for your Facebook pixel. You can turn this on. Here's where you'd enter your pixel ID and your access token, and you're all set up and ready to go. And that's really it. It's super, super simple to set up these abandoned cart emails and start recuperating some of those lost prospects. If you have any other questions on this topic or any other topic regarding Kajabi or online business, feel free to comment below because I love to answer you guys when you're leaving comments. As a matter of fact, this video is an answer to another question that I had on another video about this exact same topic. So comment below with all your questions. I definitely do my best to answer all the questions, and I may even produce a video regarding your question. So we will see you guys in the next video.